What's going on, everybody? Today we're going to be doing the comb over with a skin fade, natural part, and keep the bulb. I like to start off by combing the hair in the direction that I want it to lay in when I style it later. That way when I come in with my clippers, my clipper over comb, shear over comb, any other techniques, we're not cutting too far into the style. We're gonna start off with our number three, raking off the head right at the parietal ridge. The three helps you keep a really dark and a little bit longer, so when that bulk lays down on top, it's not gonna be too short and too hard for us to blend into later. Okay, so our first guideline we're gonna be putting in is our half clipper open, no guard. I like to do this step first on my low fades instead of doing the skin first, just because it helps me keep that dropping effect under the occipital bone without bringing it too high up at the end when I fade out my skin. The next guideline we'll be putting in is our 1.5. You can actually see where I'm gonna put this line in before. Once you start getting that eye, you can start to see the little spot by his temple peak point and go straight back to his occipital bone. Okay, so our next guideline we'll be putting in is our skin line. I like to put my skin line in with some trimmers. It helps me keep the blend a little tighter. That way when I come back with my balder also, it won't be too much of a harsh line. So now we're gonna be using our Bronze Series 8. I personally like this better than the 9. I've used both. A couple guys at my shop have the 9. These actually seem to cut longer hair. I can go through a 1.5 with these with no issue. And even if there's a little couple of stubborn hairs, it's built in with its own trimmer. Come back, touch it up. But we put this side by side with the 9, and the 9 tends to pull a little bit more hair than the 8 does. So if you're looking for a new shaver, I'd go get the 8 instead of the 9. They are a little bit more on the expensive side, so if you want a cheaper shaver, you can get the Babyliss Pro Foil. This is the smaller one with only one head. It helps me keep a tighter blend for my low fades and my blowouts. Here we're going to be doing a little trigger play. You can see since I'm left-handed, I have to use my index finger. I'm not lucky like most of you guys get to use my thumb. But I pretty much just bounce back and forth between closed, halfway, and open. I don't really go in between those. I use my corners more than going in between those notches.
$7,000 on a good shot.
Now we're going to come back and hit this line closed. We're pretty much just flicking out just at that line. You don't want to go any higher because you have that one open. So we're going to use our corners, fade out any dark spots. If you need to, you can open up the lever a little bit. But you don't want to bring the close all the way up into the open. Now we're going to be using our 16th. I really only use my 16th about halfway or closed. I don't really ever go open. a 16th open cuts to me just as much as a 1 close, so I'd rather be used by 1 close. This is our 1.5 bar. This is only on walls. I look at the wall 1.5 guard the same way as I look at my 1/16. These are like my magic little guards. A lot of people don't like them. I like to use my 1.5. It helps me keep that darkness between my 2 and my 1. But I'm pretty much just bouncing my lever between open and close, back and forth, fading out dark spots using my core. He got a haircut a week ago, so there really wasn't too much for me to line up. But we're just going over it, sharpening it up, making it crisp again. Honestly, I probably could have came in with just the razor with no trimmer. But I like to have that extra little crisp to it with the trimmer gives. Here we're just going to come in with our thinning shears, work on that bulk. I just like to feather the tips. I don't ever try to roll into the head too much because you can always take off more later, can never put it back on. So feather and then take off more. When I do the other side, I like to take a section from the apex to the corner of his tape. Sometimes I'll bring it in a little bit farther than the corner just so I can have that little hair that comes back. But I take this section for this front panel, so when I come in with my clipper, I don't take any off the front that I want to comb backwards. You can also see when I come in with my 3 here, I always brush the hair back. That's the way I'm going to style it. That's the way I'm going to cut it. Okay, so I'm just doing pretty much the same techniques as I did on the other side. I'm doing my half first. You'll see I'll roll forward with the half, and then I'll come back with it close. This is going to be more of a speed technique on the side. This is actually a 5-minute clip, so if you want to skip through this, you can just fast forward to 12 minutes. But you can see that when you're fully confident in your techniques and you know what you're doing, you know what guard you're going to pick up next, you can really bang out haircuts in a very fast, efficient time. You know, I'm sitting here showing one of my coworkers, he's a newer barber, wanted to learn some new techniques. I'm able to explain to him what I'm doing while I'm doing it and still keep this whole fade within under 5 minutes. There's a lot of barbers out here that are taking too long, taking an hour, hour and a half, and that's all fine if you're going to be charging for your time. If you're taking an hour, hour and a half, charge $50, charge $60, give a little bit more, do more of a service. But if you're in here doing 20 dollar haircuts, $15 haircuts, you should be getting them done in 15, 20 minutes. You know, if you could do this side in 5 minutes, do the other side in 5 minutes, do the top in 5 minutes, take another 5 to polish, you're done in 20, 25 minutes, easy 25, 30 all day. You know, we're here to make money, we're not here to play around. You know, barbershop's a lot of fun, hanging out, but sometimes people forget that we're here to make money and time is money.
right here, he was asking about the motion I'm using. I'm really just rolling off, flicking out at the line and the dark spots that I see. I was also explaining to him that the more light-handed you are when you're putting in guidelines and cutting hair in general, the line will be easier to take out because you're not digging it into the head. So the more flicking and more little feathering you put into it, the easier it'll be to erase the lines later. How the head shape starts to roll forward in the front. So when you want to do these haircuts, you want to maintain that length in the front. You want the front to be longer than the back. So when you go in and set your initial guideline, you're going to always want to keep the front longer and gradually get lower in the back. So that way when you comb it and style it, it can sit properly on top of the shorter hair. Here I take this middle section. Guys, don't make fun of my parting. I know my parting could be a lot better. But I like to take a middle guideline. That way I have a whole guideline throughout the whole head. It's just faster for me while I'm at work. It's hard to see from this angle, but the right side of my hand is perfectly straight. You know, we're going straight back from the highest point of the front. And we're just gonna work that line straight back, maintaining the length. Now when we come from the front, you'll be able to see your guideline closer to your knuckle. We'll be able to just go straight across. Now this guideline will be able to go through your whole head and you won't have to worry about over direction or anything like that because your guideline is already getting shorter on its own. So this was just an easier technique for me to understand when I first learned. So this is what I've always done, you know? I know there's probably better ways to be doing this, but this helped me not lose track of my guideline. So now when we even work on the right side of his head, we just take that middle part and work down at a 45 degree angle, but we're pulling straight out from his head. You know, that's the part where your head starts to roll, so we're gonna be pulling 90 degrees from that. To make this transition smooth, we're gonna pull the hair straight out and go vertically up. You don't wanna roll into the head because you'll take off too much length. Also, if the client's head isn't sitting straight up, you will also cut off too much length like he is right here. Always make sure your client is sitting perfectly straight up. They don't realize that when their head is leaning to one side or another, you will cut more off and it will be uneven. Now, when it comes to styling these haircuts, you want to work in the back first. Blow dry your crown down, lay it in the direction it wants to lay. Make sure there's no alfalfas. And also another reason you want to work in the back first is because you don't want to blow dry the front section, lean it back, and it sit on top of wet hair. Because if it's on top of wet hair, it's just gonna get wet underneath. It's gonna take you longer to get the style you want. You're not gonna get what you're looking for. So work that back section, blow dry it back. You see here, I combed that front section back down we were working with before. Blow dry everything back, and then we'll be able to come back with the front. And you'll get your finished product. Now, if you're having trouble with working this front section, getting it to stand up and get your volume, what you could do is blow dry it backwards and twist your wrists. It'll grip the hair and you can blow dry and pull out from the scalp. Now, if you want, you could also hold it there and it'll lock it, but you'll get more of that bend look instead of it just being more of a natural flow. Also, another trick to help lock that in is hit it with a cool shot. My blow dryer doesn't have a cool shot, so I just had to switch it to cold. But once you hit it with cold air, it's gonna close up that follicle. It's the same thing if you're doing like a hot towel shave. That hot air is gonna open up them follicles, sit it how you want, and then once you hit it with your cool shot, it'll lock it into place. Now this part isn't necessary, but these are little things I like to add into my style cuts. Just adding some texture with some point cutting. You're going in, and as you're pulling out, you close your blade. You know, you will nick yourself. Oh well, get over it. It's little things like this that set you apart from other barbers. Clients like to see things like this. I literally have made clients just because they said they like to see how fancy I am, when in actuality, it's really nothing different. To help style it off, I like to throw a little Big Sexy Hair powder play. This helps give a little texture, a little grip. It'll make that point cutting you just did pop out even more. It's really simple to style with, and also you just run your fingers through it. You already did the blow dry, you already did the hard work. So once you add that powder play, it pretty much just falls into place. Gives you a nice little texture, little feathered look. You can send him on his way. That's pretty much it, guys. You know, sorry I had to get this on my phone. My camera died right when I finished, but I got that 11 Max Pro, so nobody can talk crap. Got that high quality. You know, we go back in there, see a little few things here and there that could have been fixed. But that's what we're all here for. We're all here to learn and get better. You guys get better every day. I get better every day. You know, I love doing these videos because I really can now go back and see my work, what I need to work on, what I need to touch up. Also see where I can get better. You know, I did this haircut for a competition last week, placed third place. I was pretty disappointed with myself. Felt like I could have done better. But you know, it's all good. On to the next one. Appreciate y'all tuning in this week. Sorry for the delay. We'll be back next Monday. Go like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what haircuts you guys want to see. I'll do my best to get on that. If you want to stay for the last few minutes, it's just me cutting his hair off. He was tired of styling it. Just wants to wake up and go. But all right, see y'all next week. Peace.